times, many ways. Merry Christmas to you.
I'm back, and I'm here to save Christmas. I'm here to save 2020 as best as I can. And in doing so, I'm here with my 2020 Festive Film Series. Did you really think I was going to let you all go into the new year without giving you it? Don't worry, you can stop the press, stop panicking. I'm here to deliver the Festive Film Series to you right now. I know you've been waiting on it, all like two of you who watch my videos. I'm back. It's been a while since I've actually sat down and done a video. I can't actually remember what the last video was that I uploaded, but I'm back. 2020, we can all agree, has been a bit shite, so I've not had much to film like I normally would, but you know, I'm here now, so that's the main thing. I've got my Christmas tree. The lights are, they're gonna go off and on, so I do apologise if that's a bit distracting, but just look at what's right in front of you. Do you like my new hair? I got a haircut about a month ago actually, and I got a fringe. I just felt like it's more of a, it's like a mullet kind of thing. I kind of like it, so. And it's red for Christmas. Can you see that? Lovely. I didn't dye it for Christmas though, considering it was a month ago when I got it done. But we'll just pretend it is. 2020, much like previous years, do have their own fair share of Christmas films, and I'm here to review some of them. I have watched a lot, mainly because I'm done with university now and I've got time just to sit and watch films, which is good for someone like me because I do a film degree, so you know, it all correlates. The first film of the series that we're going to be reviewing today is The Princess Switch Switched Again, which is the second, the sequel to the first film, The Princess Switch, which I reviewed last year, by the way. Hint, hint, go watch it. You don't actually need to watch the film. Well, actually, maybe you do. If you've not seen the first one, the second one might be a bit confusing because obviously it's a continuation, but don't worry, I'll keep you right. So let's just get into it.
I'm Stacy, and this is Duchess Margaret. We met 2 years ago and changed each other's lives forever. I married Prince Edward, and Margaret dated my friend Kevin. They tried to make it work, but soon learned long distance is harder than it looks. Which brings me back to the old bakery to see how Kevin's doing.
I've moved on.
Really?
Yeah.
Margaret needs us to be there for her.
Stacy, I'm so happy you're here.
There's no way we'd miss your coronation. And
got you a little surprise.
I hope it's okay that we're here.
I know it in my heart. You and Kevin are meant to be.
Ah, there's the sugar.
I'll get it.
I'll
give you money. What in the world is going on here?
Antonio, I wasn't expecting you until tomorrow morning.
What's the deal with you and Antonio?
I've known Antonio forever.
I just want you to know I'm here for you. Whatever you need, whenever you need me.
But the fact is, Kevin and I haven't even begun to talk about what went wrong between us. With the coronation coming up,
I don't know if we ever will.
I have a great idea.
You want us to do what?
Switch back.
You said you needed more time with Kevin.
Do you really think we could pull it off? Again?
Does that mean you'll do it?
Did you talk this over with Kevin?
Margaret's in. I'm in.
Finishing touches, rings.
Feels weird taking it off.
Even better than last time.
I'll tell Edward everything as soon as it's over.
Any for your thoughts?
Ah, yes. Stroll a day keeps the bad weather away.
Oh, no.
What could possibly come between two people who look at each other like that?
Presenting Lady Fiona Pembroke.
Maggie Moo. Oh. Double chin, that's a delete.
Here we go.
This is my cousin, Fiona.
Oh, dear Lord, there are three of them.
Why can't I pull the switch?
Be queen.
Off with their heads.
The Princess Switch 2, or to give it its official name, The Princess Switch Switched Again, is a Christmas rom-com directed by Michael Rowell. I hope I'm saying that right. And it stars Vanessa Hudgens, who's the main character times three now. Right, okay, the first film, there was Stacey De Novo, and she was a baker. She got invited to a baking contest because she's good at baking, and the Royal Margaret Princess, that's a really good description, Princess Margaret, right? They both look the same, which is, I get it, like people have doppelgangers, right? They don't usually look identical, but I get it. Odd coincidence that they both look the same. And then Stacey fell in love with Margaret's love interest, and then Margaret fell in love with Stacey's friend, who I guess Stacey and Kevin, his name is, they had a sort of thing for each other, but then they both fell in love with the other one's man. So that made sense. Total end of the story. And then they released the trailer for this film, which I watched it and I thought, oh my god, they've done it again. They've switched again. But they've not only switched again. There's a third Vanessa Hudgens, which, I mean, two's fine. But then three people who look exactly the same. It's a bit weird, isn't it? So, to give you a brief synopsis, the heir to the throne suddenly dies, which means Margaret now has to step up and be the next in line because there's no one else to fill the role. So she's now queen. So she's like to Stacey and Kevin, hey, I'm about to be queen, I'm a bit nervous, can you come help me out please? And they're like, sure, well, we will fly over and greet you. Now obviously Stacey's a princess because she married Prince Edward. So they're all royal now. Margaret and Kevin, they were dating, but then all the royal stuff happened, so they broke off their relationship. So Stacey's like, Kevin, I need you to come with me. You need to fix things with Margaret, she really needs you. And Kevin's like, I don't know, it's a bit awkward going to see your ex. I can imagine it's awkward to see your ex. So, but he comes anyway because he's a nice man. And they're all thankful to be there. And Margaret's like, I really appreciate your help. And then there's a third one. Third princess royal person has entered the scene. This third person is called Fiona. She is the cousin of Margaret. And she's blonde, and she's just the antagonist of the film. Basically, she wants the throne and she wants the money so that her and her friends, these like weird sidekicks that just follow her about basically, they want the money so they can go to, I think it's Capri they said. Very nice, I must say. So she enters the scene and she's like, oh, what was she? She calls Margaret Maggie Moo, which I think is quite funny. I have to say, credit where credit's due, Vanessa Hudgens does a really good British accent, and though they all look identical, you can tell them all apart, and each character has their own arc, which is good. It's not like they've just jumbled Vanessa Hudgens over three roles and you don't know who's who, so it's good. One of the things I found amusing was that one of Fiona's wee sidekicks is Ricky Norwood, who played Fat Boy in EastEnders. I looked at him and I was like, he looks a bit familiar. Went on the old IMDb and there he is, wee Fat Boy from EastEnders. If you don't know what EastEnders, oh, there we go, the tree's going a bit crazy. If you don't know what EastEnders is, it's a British soap based in the East End, I guess, of London. I don't really watch soaps, but my mother does. So sometimes it's just on. And I just recognised, I just thought it was really funny that he was in it. So she wants the throne from Margaret. Margaret and Stacey have swapped places because Stacey wants Margaret and Kevin to sort out their problems, but they don't have opportunities to talk. So there's an event that Margaret needs to go to. It's like a choir, it's like the children's choir. For Christmas, so Stacey's like, I'll go there as you and you go as me with Kevin, and then talk to him. And then they're like, shall we switch again? We've done it again. Can't believe we've gotten away with it. And then Fiona is also at this children's choir thing because she wants to swap places with who she thinks is Margaret. And she goes through the whole thing of changing her whole appearance. So she goes from a long hair blonde, like really dramatic makeup, to the simple makeup and short black hair of, I guess, now Queen Margaret. I keep calling her princess. She's a queen now. Spoiler alert, she goes through with the queen thing, so she's now a queen. But then she kidnaps Margaret, who's actually Stacy, and then Stacy goes back to the palace as Margaret, but then goes upstairs thinking Margaret, who is Fiona, like, okay, we can switch back now because the deed is done. But then Fiona's pretending to be Margaret, which confuses it's confusing me. But then to officiate the ceremony of her becoming a queen, there's obviously the big ceremony to give her the crown, and she does an oath to say that, oh, I will rule this country for my people and stuff. But Fiona rushes the whole process and says, no, we're not going to do it tomorrow, we're going to do it today. And they do it in the evening, and then the guy who's doing it has no idea that the person in front of him isn't Margaret, it's Fiona. And then Stacy and Margaret, because they find Stacy, they get her back after her being kidnapped, they go to the church where this is all happening, and they're like, hang on a second, mate. That is not Margaret, that's Margaret. But then that's Stacy. They all just look the same. So she's gonna get arrested, and then she doesn't get arrested. She just gets, I think it's like community service or something, because Margaret's nice and she's friendly. But then she becomes the queen. But before that, Kevin and his daughter have left because Fiona, as Margaret, told him, oh, our relationship would never work. I need to become a queen and I can't do it with you. So he's like, right, after all we talked about, I have to leave now. See you later. But they stop him at the airport. And then, by coincidence, there's a vicar at the airport waiting on his flight. And Margaret and Kevin go up to him and they're like, can you officiate a wedding for us right here, right now? And he's like, sure, but I've got 5 minutes to my flight, and there's a tannoy that keeps going off for his flight, and it's just a running joke, like, oh, I have to go for my flight now, ha ha ha, do you take him to be your husband and all that? And then they get married in the airport. It's good. And then the ceremony for her becoming, the coronation happens for her becoming queen, and Kevin's beside her as the king. He's not the king. Is he the king? As her partner, her beloved, her man's, they're back together again. And there's an Easter egg at the end. Queen Amber and King Richard from A Christmas Prince are at the ceremony, which I thought was awesome. It was like a wee nod. I was expecting A Christmas Prince 4 to come out this Christmas, but I've been disappointed and they've not done it. Maybe next year. I have to say, I did actually enjoy this film. I enjoyed it more than I thought I would, but I just thought, see if they release a third one when there's four of them that look the same. I think they would have been flogging a dead horse at that point. But if they just leave it as the first two films, then that's it. I get it. Like, it's fine. Thank you very much for watching. It was a bit of a rushed one. I do apologise. I had a lot to talk about and not much time to do so. So, this has been the first episode of my Festive Film Series 2020. I hope to stick around for the next few episodes. I'm predicting there's going to be at least four, so it'll be good. And I hope to see you next time. Watch this space.